Now, in real life, if I want to keep other people from taking my things or messing with things they shouldn't, I use a lock to stop them. In threaded programming, we use a similar concept to protect memory. Let's say that inside some procedure, there's a block where I manipulate some data, in our example, the variable A. And I need to be sure that no other thread touches this variable while I'm working on it, whether executing this procedure or another one. Well, then I can declare a lock variable, which should reside in shared memory, and put the lock on before I begin my manipulation, and unlock it afterwards. And I should do the same wherever I manipulate this variable A. If some other thread running this code simply accesses the shared resource without using the lock, it won't be able to stop him. But if he does try to acquire the lock first, then this call to Mutex Lock will block until the lock variable shows that it has been unlocked, and only then will this code proceed. And of course, if the schedule had worked things out so that this call had been called first, then he would get the lock, and this call to acquire the Mutex lock would block until this data manipulation was finished and the Mutex variable had been unlocked. In this way, the threads are able to mutually exclude each other from using resources. Hence, these are called Mutex locks.